those beautiful children. Now it's time to run up to bed.
But teacher, it's Christmas Eve. Do we have to go to bed already?
Yes, it is Christmas Eve, which means tomorrow is...
Christmas!
The day we celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior.
Jesus!
That's right. Now you wouldn't want to be sleepy on Christmas, would you?
No.
No. So, off to bed with you. Yes. Good night. Good night. It will be wonderful. Good night. See you tomorrow. Good night. Louise? Louise, what's the matter, dear?
I don't want to go to bed. It's dark. I'm scared of the dark. I miss my mama and papa, and I feel so lonely.
Oh, the dark can feel rather lonesome, can't it?
And I failed my test today. Why do I have to learn to read? It's so hard.
Oh, I suppose it is, but reading is very, very important, Louise. Words are powerful.
They are?
Yes, especially God's word. It can bring us hope when we feel hopeless, and comfort when we're lonely, and help in the darkest place.
But how can you read in the dark? Then you can't see the words.
I suppose not. But God's word is powerful enough to take us from the darkness and bring us into the light.
I don't think I understand.
Well, how would you like a story, Louise?
I like stories.
Excellent. Well, have you ever heard of Marguerite de la Roque?
No. Was she a real person?
Oh, indeed she was.
Marguerite Bellabock! She sounds beautiful.
Oh, she was beautiful on the outside, but on the inside, she was spoiled and selfish. She was the only child born into a noble family of great wealth.
My father's a noble. That's why I got to live at school.
That's why you get to live at school. Now, unfortunately, Marguerite's parents both died when she was young. And the inheritance left to her were large amounts of land, as well as half of the family home, Pond Point.
Pond Point! It sounds marvelous!
Oh, it was.
But you said she only got half. Who got the other half?
Her uncle, Jean-Francois de la Roque de Roberval!
Jean-Francois de la Roque de Roberval!
Oui, but he preferred to be called Sir Roberval. He got the other half of the estate and was now Marguerite's legal guardian.
Pond Point. It sounds grand.
Oh, it was grand. But I'm afraid it was not big enough for the both of them.
Good afternoon, Demian.
Marguerite, where have you been? Your tutor waited for you half the afternoon, and now the Christmas mask begins in only 2 hours.
Oh, Demian, the Christmas mask! A whole house full of people? I can hardly endure another boring afternoon practicing my reading. Oh, I'm far too excited!
I can't say I blame you. Monsieur Garner doesn't seem to be the most interesting of people.
The most interesting? Oh, he's as dry as dust.
Please follow along while I read you to sleep.
You silly goose.
I despise studies. Oh, I love parties. Dancing. Oh, I'm happiest when I'm dancing.
That's true. But you should not neglect your studies. Reading is a great privilege, one I could only imagine.
One I would gladly forego.
But imagine, Marguerite, being able to read the Word of God for yourself. Your mother did leave you her copy of the Holy Scriptures. She taught me to love them, and she longed for you to love them too.
Why would I? Books are boring.
Not the Word of God, Marguerite. It lives and speaks and...
I'm not as good as you, Demian. Oh, you're a Huguenot and a fine example of one, pious and good. But I have no desire to be good. Well, it spoils all my fun.
I am not good, Marguerite. It is God who is good.
Well, I'm happy that works for you, Demian. I'm happy that works for you, Demian. But I have no need of God. Well, I have my friends and you and a whole party to look forward to. Oh, how should we do my hair?
Well, you haven't left me much time, but I suppose we could plait it. It is the newest fashion.
Oh, I wish I was blonde.
I hear that some of the women in court wear false hair made of yellow silk.
I would never do that. Well, I think they would look ridiculous. But just imagine being in court. How resplendent! I wish I could go!
Sir Roberval has just returned from court, has he not?
Yes, and he wouldn't take me with him. Oh, I wish I could travel, Demian. It would be so exciting. Oh, just imagine. I begged and I begged him to let me go, but he refused. Well, I shall never forgive Uncle.
Roberval.
Ah, Claude. How good of you to come early upon my request.
Welcome back. And how was the court of King Francis?
Magnificent. I do enjoy every moment in court.
You spend a lot of time there. And in which of his 8 castles did you find him this time?
I met him at Fontainebleau.
Ah, his favorite. Spared no expense. He imported the Italians to design it.
Never have I seen such architect. Entire corridors lined with paintings and sculptures. He has pieces from Leonardo da Vinci and Michelangelo.
Ah, to be king of France.
He has led us into the future of the 16th century. A new era of artistic expression, an era of intellect and exploration, which is why I've called you here early.
You have news?
That I do. As you know, Jacques Cartier has returned from the country of Canadas, from the kingdom of Seguin, as it has been called, bringing back news of fine furs, diamonds, gems, and gold.
Ah, the riches to be had.
King Francis has decided to send back another expedition to the Canadas. But this time, to set up a new colony. He calls it New France.
Yes, I know. And he commissions Jacques Cartier to lead it again.
Not anymore, my good man. Standing before you is the newly commissioned Lieutenant General of New France.
Instead of Cartier? You must be joking. How on earth did you manage that?
Let's just say King Francis had a change of heart.
And I suppose you being childhood friends who hunted and wrestled together didn't hurt either, I suppose. And of course you convinced him you were the man for the job.
I reminded him that I was an expert in fortification, a master of mines in France, and a noble soldier.
Very shrewd. All the important assets that would be useful for establishing a colony.
Exactly. He has wisely placed me in command of the entire expedition. I have waited for an opportunity like this my entire life. Finally, I shall have wealth and prestige.
And Cartier?
Oh, he shall still go. I need his experience, but I shall be in command.
Incredible.
Yes, and that is where you come in, Claude. For the past 20 years, we have served in the military together and fought side by side in war.
Here we go.
I did save your life. Took you right out of the way of that speeding bullet.
You tripped me.
Nevertheless, you were alive. Thus, you owe me. My request is this. Would you consider accompanying me as first mate to New France?
And do hard labor on a ship? You must be joking.
No, we have prisoners for that. King Francis figured he could kill 2 birds with 1 stone.
Oh, I hate birds. The more dead birds, the better, I say.
I mean, he came up with a brilliant plan to fix two problems at the same time.
And how did he manage that?
King Francis figured he could empty out the overcrowded prisons of France and send the prisoners to build the new colony. See? Two birds with one stone. They can also do the hard labor on the ship.
So let me get this straight. You want me to sail across the ocean with thieves and murderers and then live in a crude and rustic colony with them? Think again.
A colony filled with fine furs, diamonds, gems, and gold.
Furs, diamonds, and gems.
And gold, just for the taking, Claude. We shall be rich.
Gold. I do like gold. I guess I do owe it to you. You saved my life, after all. All right, I accept.
Excellent.
And what about the birds?
Confounded man, forget about the birds, Claude. You will make the big announcement at the Christmas mosque tonight.
The Christmas mosque is soon to begin. Are you almost finished, Damien?
Hold still, Marguerite. These things take time. But you didn't leave me much of. Where did you disappear to this afternoon anyway?
Well, I went over to the Monet's for tea.
And did you also forget that you had an art lesson this afternoon?
Oh, yes, well, tea was much more fun. Three handsome sons. I can hardly decide which one of them to choose. All three are eligible.
And did you also forget that you had an art lesson this afternoon?
Well, yeah. I went to the Monet's for tea, didn't I just say? Three handsome sons, which I don't know which one to decide. I don't know, it's so hard.
Do you think of nothing other than young men?
Well, what else is there to think of? I'm 18 years old and have been cooped up in this house long enough with Uncle Roberval. Well, he cares nothing of me. All he wants is the inheritance of Pond Point all to himself.
But you
he's so greedy.
But you do own half, dear.
And he certainly resents me for that. But if I get married, oh, I shall be free of him and his control.
Well, I will agree with you on one thing. Sir Roberval is a man full of greed.
45,000 livres. That's all King Francis gave me to finance this expedition.
Can you finance the rest yourself, then?
I'm afraid I cannot. I made a large investment recently, and it has proved disastrous. I find myself in the unfortunate position of heavy debt.
You, Roberval? Debt? Truly, no one would ever suspect.
And I hope to keep it that way. My plan is to borrow what I need and recoup my losses in the Canadas, or I don't know what will become of me. My creditors will eat me alive.
Well then, we shall just have to find treasure. And who says we can't pirate the English ships along the way, hey? I hear they're loaded with goods just for our taking on the high seas.
Claude, you are brilliant. It's all settled then. The only matter that is unresolved is what to do with that Marguerite while I am away.
What do you mean?
She is irresponsible and self-centered. That is what I mean. I fear leaving her here unsupervised. Who knows what she will do?
She does seem quite free-spirited.
Free-spirited? She has no sense. My steward told me she called for the coach today and went to the Monet's for afternoon tea.
So?
Such things are not to be done. What will people say? She'll be the ruin of me with her foolish behavior.
Don't the Monet's have two sons?
Three, actually. She's far too friendly with all of them.
So, if you leave her here...
She is sure to marry one of them while I am away.
And the estates, being side by side, will be combined. And you will lose controlling power.
That cannot happen. I'm almost in financial ruin as is. I need Pond Point. Without it, surely I am finished.
Well then, why don't you take her along?
To New France?
She wouldn't be able to marry away the family fortune then, could she?
You have a point there.
And you say she's always pestering you about taking her places?
Constantly. She wanted to go to the court of King Francis with me.
Exactly. If you take her to New France, you will be able to control her. Give her what she wants. Let her travel the world.
Travel the world, Damien! Oh, that's what I want. Get out of these confining walls, meet new people, and then I shall be happy. With my parents both passing, well, I get so lonely, especially at night. Oh, how I hate the darkness.
Marguerite, You are never alone.
That's because I have you, Damien.
That's not what I mean. The very reason we celebrate tonight is because of Emmanuel, God with us. When we have him, he is all we need.
And I'm happy that works for you, sweet Damien. Oh, you must know you are like a sister to me. My wise older sister.
Wise, maybe, but not old. I'm only 2 years your elder.
Oh, and my dearest friend, you do know how much I love you, don't you? We shall never be apart, for I could not survive without you. Well, who would dress me?
Who indeed?
Oh, promise me you will never leave me.
Marguerite, I am not the one you truly need. But I promise, as far as I am able, that I will never leave you.
And when I get married, I shall take you with me.
That may be so, but I intend to get married myself one day.
Why, Damien, I didn't know you thought of such things.
Of course I do, silly. You're not the only one who longs for male companionship. I shall marry a tall, handsome man of my own.
Oh, then we shall both be married, and you and he can both serve me. What if I meet the man of my dreams tonight at the Christmas mask? He may be here. Oh, just imagine.
You shall meet your nobleman, and perhaps I shall meet his coachman.
And we shall live happily ever after.
In the sticks, the royal court is where my heart is now affixed. The future brilliant, inlaid with gold. Yes, my future will be bright. Childling, my ball and chain. Without her money, I will never reach my aim. If I could only find some release from this hassle in my life. See my estate rise high above all. Show them all, just wait and see. Show them how
here would never end. I cannot face it. growing up, I am still scared of the dark.
Stay on this sun, not on a day. We could go most anywhere.
All of you, a very Merry Christmas on this, the first of the 12 days of Christmas. I would now like to call up Monsieur Claude Fontaine to make a very special announcement.
I am pleased to announce that King Francis I of France, in this year 1541, has commissioned our very own Roberval.
Sir Roberval.
Sir Roberval, as the Lieutenant General of New France.
Thank you very much. It is with humility and honor that I have accepted the title and position of Lieutenant General of Canada. This expedition, which I shall lead, will travel up the St. Lawrence Valley to establish a colony. We shall also explore beyond that in hopes of finding the Northwest Passage. I am looking for fine noblemen and noblewomen such as yourselves to accompany me on this new and exciting voyage where we shall become the first settlers of the Canadas. Of course, you won't be expected to work during the voyage. We have men for that. We shall depart from La Rochelle. Cartier will leave first, and we shall join him thereafter. I hope that some of you will consider. Now please, enjoy the party!
Yes, Madame Blanchet. Very exciting.
And I suppose you will need strong women to accompany the men to begin your colony?
Yes, we will indeed.
Allow me to present my daughter, Georgette Blanchet.
Mother!
She would make a fine catch for any young man, Sir Robert. She's already been proposed to once.
Mother!
But alas, he went off to war and never returned. Broke the poor girl's heart, he did. But she's over it now and ready to move on.
I am happy to hear that. She's over it, I mean. We will certainly be glad to have her.
Yes, madame, by any means possible.
Wonderful. Did you hear that, Mr. Blanchet? They would be happy to have Georgette.
Yes, dear.
Now, you mustn't mind me as I pride myself in being a woman who speaks her mind. Isn't that right, Monsieur Blanchet?
Yes, dear.
So, I must ask, what is it that has happened to your eye?
Mother!
What? He's wearing an eye patch. I doubt it's for fashion purposes, is it, monsieur?
No, madame. I assure you it is not for fashion.
Please, if you'll excuse me.
Unfortunately, I lost vision in my eye when I saved a child from a burning building.
Did you hear that? Monsieur Fontaine was blinded by rescuing a child from a burning building, no less.
Oh, how
noble of you.
Oh, how wonderfully brave of him.
You wouldn't have any room on the boat for me, would you?
Ah, congratulations, Sir Roberval.
Thank you, Monsieur Dupont.
Lieutenant General, that is a feather in your hat, I say.
What did you say about his cat?
No, I said a feather in his hat.
Oh, yes, that. Yes, of course. You should be proud, Sir Roberval. A few feathers, I dare say.
And when do you plan to depart on this grand exploration of yours?
The 16th day of April, 1542. And which of you fine gentlemen care to join us? You, Monsieur Lambert?
Me, you say? Oh, no. I fear I am far too old for such things now. But perhaps if I was a younger man...
Sign me up, Sir Roberval.
Truly.
I can think of no greater way than to serve king and country in this manner. I am at your service.
Excellent, Monsieur Dupont. What an adventure we shall have. And what of you, Monsieur André?
Oh, I love adventure. But the high seas are not for me, I'm afraid. Too much water for my liking. I will stay right here on solid ground.
A land lover, hey?
As you say.
Oh, Uncle Roberval, please may I go? I long to travel and see the world. Just imagine crossing the ocean! Oh, how exciting!
Marguerite, your manners! Gentlemen, please allow me to introduce Marguerite de la Roque, my niece.
Pleasure.
Pleasure's all mine.
I beg you! Oh, please let me go just this once!
You may go.
Please, I will not complain! Just think of the education it would... Wait, what?
I said you may go.
To New France, with you?
Yes.
Ah, thank you, Uncle Roberval, thank you. I take back all the mean things I ever said about you, thank you.
That's enough, now off with you.
Oh, I must go tell my friends. Georgette, Camille, Maria, get to
know. Those are some excited young ladies you have there.
Ah, the exuberance of
you. Clumsy girl, look at what you have done!
I didn't mean to.
My apologies, Monsieur Lambert.
Now, Roberval. Don't you worry. I forgive you.
What? No, it was her.
Sometimes I'm just a clumsy old fool, too. It wasn't all your fault.
It was her fault, and I assure you, she will be soundly punished.
Clearly it was an accident, Sir Roberval.
I'm sorry.
Her actions are unforgivable. She will certainly be punished. Now, please, if you'll excuse us.
Please have mercy, Sir Roberval.
It would seem Sir Roberval is not one to have mercy.
It would appear not. But I'm afraid that those who live by the sword will die by the sword.
Oh, I am so relieved to hear that you shall be coming, Marguerite, my dear friend.
Just think of all the handsome men we shall meet.
It's over.
And there's so many here tonight.
Far too many men. I hate parties. Why must we all dance around like butterflies? I would much rather...
Have your nose in a book?
Please, forgive the interruption, ladies.
Oh, it's no interruption, I assure you.
Please, allow me to introduce Monsieur Dupont.
I'm Camille.
Oh, and this is Georgette and Marie.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
Marie, what sorts of things do you enjoy doing?
Reading.
Oh, magnificent.
And you, I believe, are Marguerite. And quite lovely at that.
Why, thank you, Monsieur André.
Please, call me Nicholas.
Well, if you insist. And what sort of things do you fill your day with, Nicholas?
All of the sorts of things you would expect, I suppose. I ride, I hunt stags, foxes.
Have you ever shot a wolf?
I have. I shot a big one. I shot right at those yellow eyes as it hunted me in the darkness.
Oh, how horrible, how terrifying! Both wolves and the dark, those are my two worst fears. When I hear a wolf howl at night, oh, my skin crawls!
Yes, wolves are clever. They reveal themselves to you, and while you're watching one, another one sneaks up behind you.
Oh, how horrible!
Have no fear, my good lady. I will protect you from all the wolves of France.
Oh, why, thank you, my brave hunter.
I could teach you someday if you would like.
To hunt?
To shoot.
Oh, a real gun?
Why not?
Well, who ever heard of a woman hunting?
And why not, I ask you?
You certainly do not think like most men do.
No, I suppose I do not. But why must things always be done the same way, for no other reason than that is the way they've always been done?
I really don't know.
We're living in a changing world, the 16th century. I am not afraid to try new things.
You really are an unconventional thinker, aren't you?
Thank you for the compliment.
And how about a trip to New France? Oh, does that sound like something new you would like to try?
Are you going on this trip?
I am.
Then I had already made up my mind to go.
Wonderful. Please, let's dance. You wouldn't happen to have a coachman here by any chance, would you?
No, I'm afraid I arrived on horseback. Why?
Well, never mind. Oh, it doesn't matter.
Demian.
Oh, he is brave. My Nicholas is scared of nothing.
My only consolation on this wretched voyage is that we are surrounded by men. Which to choose?
Georgette's only consolation on this voyage is that her mother isn't here to choose one for her.
It is true.
I think Mr. DuPont is a nice man.
Mr. DuPont is an absolute oaf!
He is not, Camille. He is a fine gentleman.
Oh, I only have eyes for one man.
Only one?
You and Nicholas must have hit it off.
Yes, he makes me completely happy.
You spent every waking moment with him before we left. And now you watch him constantly.
Well, that's because he's wonderful, Damien. The man I've always dreamed of.
But do you think it's wise, Marguerite? All the time you spend with him? Sir Roberval has instructed us ladies to keep to ourselves during this voyage, and he certainly doesn't seem to approve of you and Nicholas.
My uncle approves of nothing I do. And I don't care. I shall do as I want.
Please just be careful, Marguerite.
Blasted birds! Confounded creatures! Get out of here! Get out of here, I say! Take that, you foul! Sailor, take the wheel for me.
Sir!
Pierre, what is the reading?
Marguerite's 14 knots, sir.
Excellent. We are making good time. The captain will want to record that in his logbook. Let go clue lines and bunt lines. Captain on deck!
Status report, Monsieur Fontaine.
Wind is from the northwest, 22. We just measured and we are making 14 knots.
Good. I will make an entry in my logbook. You, sailor, go and get my logbook from my quarterdeck. What is this? A coin? And where would you get a coin? Why, you thief! You good-for-nothing scoundrel! I could have you hanged for this!
Captain! It's only 5 under! Surely you would not have a man hanged for such petty theft!
I most certainly would! These men are nothing but a worthless lot of thieves and murderers! I should
have
left you to rot!
Please have mercy, Sir
Roberval! Claude, see that this man is flogged!
Yes,
no!
Captain!
No! Please, Captain!
Get him!
Please! No! No!
Is that really necessary?
Let that be a lesson to the rest of you! Mr. DuPont, may I remind you that I am the captain of this ship? Do not interfere with my business again!
Roberval is a fool. If he turns the men against him, this colony will be a dismal failure.
Aren't you afraid of these men? They're dangerous thieves and murderers after all.
Most aren't so bad. I've talked to them. Some of them just fell on hard times. Work with them, and they'll help you. But Roberval, he is making enemies.
Oh, he's so cruel to have a man flogged for such a small crime. And that horrible Monsieur Claude. Well, I don't trust that man. And why do you think he hates birds so much? They always seem to be going after him.
It's the prisoners' doing.
What on earth are you talking about?
They know how much he hates birds. So they put fish guts in his hat to attract them.
Oh, how clever.
It's their way of getting the last laugh.
Well, serves him right. Oh, just look, Nicholas. We are explorers on the St. Anne. Oh, isn't she a wonderful ship? And just look at the water.
Yes, the water.
Oh, I love the smell of salt and the spray on my face, don't you?
Absolutely.
And look there, all the Valentine Anne and the Lesfray sails with us. How glorious their white sails are, full in the wind. Water in every direction as far as the eye can see.
So I noticed.
And I get to enjoy it all with you. Thank you for your letter. I read it over and over again before I went to sleep last night.
You are by far the best part of this voyage, Marguerite.
Well, I could not bear being apart from you, even for a day.
We will never be apart. You are the love of my life.
And you, my brave and handsome man, are everything I need.
Marguerite, Monsieur André, I believe I have made my orders clear. Keep to yourself, Marguerite. Monsieur André, the bilge water needs hauled out from below deck. You will see to it.
You clearly stated that the noblemen of this voyage would not have to work. I will appeal to a higher authority.
I am the Governor General of this expedition, appointed by King Francis himself. There is no higher authority, Monsieur André. If you will not obey my orders, I assure you, there will be consequences.
Yes, sir.
Marguerite, the way you carry on with that young man is a disgrace to the family name. I will not have it.
Me? A disgrace?
Have you no sense of decency for what is proper?
Proper? You would have a man flogged for such a small crime!
I am the captain of this ship! I will maintain law and order for all of those under me, including you! If you will not obey my orders and keep your distance, I will have you confined to your quarters for the rest of the voyage! Do I make myself clear?
Yes, Captain. He makes me so angry! Oh, I despise him!
Do you really think that he can keep you two apart?
He likes to think he can, but he can't.
Why are you smiling? What are you up to?
We get around his rules.
Marguerite!
How do you do it?
We have a secret system. Nicholas and I can talk to each other whenever we want to. Watch this. See?
How did you persuade him to do that?
Well, the men like Nicholas. They would do anything for him. And it doesn't hurt that I also pay a little extra per letter. We both win.
Marguerite!
Is that allowed?
Of course not, Marie. Don't be silly. It's brilliant, Marguerite. Marguerite, the problem with secrets is that the truth always has a way of coming out. What if Monsieur Claude or Sir Roberval find that letter?
Damien, I love you, but you worry far too much. My secret is safe. Oh, now fetch my brush so you can work on my hair. Oh, I think it's getting lighter in the sun.
Thank you. looking into my skin. May is my favorite month.
It does feel wonderful not to be ill anymore. At least it only lasted a week.
Sailing is much more enjoyable when you don't feel like you're about to die.
Why, hello, sleepyhead.
Marguerite, you're awake at last.
Are you feeling any better? We let you sleep in.
Oh, quite honestly, no. Oh, I feel terrible. The sun is so hot. Is there no shade to be had? Damien, I think I need some more water.
I just gave you some, Marguerite. We do have to ration it, you know. Come sit down, and I'll rub your back.
How strange that your seasickness only hit after 3 weeks.
It will be over soon, Marguerite. Soon we shall near the New World, and we shall enter the mouth of the Saint Laurent. And then, look, we see islands already!
Islands? And is that a boat? Who could that be way over there?
Basque fishermen, I imagine. I've read about them. They have rights to fish off the coast of Terre-Neuve, and then they return to Europe with their catch of fish.
Oh, do not speak of fish. I feel dreadful enough, and I threw up all morning.
She throws up every morning, but she always seems to feel better after lunch. Oh, Marguerite.
Would you like some hardtack, Marguerite?
Oh, I cannot stand the sight of food.
Marguerite, I need a word with you.
What, Damien?
Over here, Marguerite.
Fine. What is it?
For over a week, you have been very tired, nauseous in the morning, and cannot stand the sight of food. Marguerite!
What?
What, Damien? What is wrong with you? Marguerite, are you with child?
What? With child? What on earth are you talking about?
Marguerite, could it be possible?
Damien, don't be ridiculous. Why would you even ask me such a thing?
Answer my question.
No. Of course I'm not with child.
Tell me the truth.
Well, I suppose it could be possible.
Marguerite, no! What you have done is wrong.
Oh, could it be true, Damien? With child? No, it can't be true. If it is true, what will my uncle say? Oh, Damien, what am I going to do?
I have no idea. But I suppose Nicholas should be the first to know.
No, I can't tell Nicholas. Oh, I suppose I must tell him. Quick, Damien, oh, something to write on. I'll send him a letter.
Claude!
Captain on deck!
As you were.
Is it just me? Or does Sir Roberval's hat have more feathers every day?
It's almost as big as his head.
There. Now to get it to Nicholas. Oh, Damien, I shall like to lie down. Come and get me settled.
I'm going to take Marguerite back to her quarters.
Oh, poor dear. I hope you feel better soon, Marguerite.
You, sailor, pull that line.
Yes, sir.
Two hands, sailor. Put some muscle into it. Blasted birds! Get out of here! Get out of here, I said!
The eye patch. It was a bird that blinded him.
What? But he said he hurt his eye saving a child from a burning building.
'Tis not true. He entered a barn and a swallow flew in his eye, blind as a bat.
There's nothing noble about that.
A swallow, really?
How do you know this, Georgette?
Oh, my mother. She went on and on saying about that rumor that he had saved that child, but someone set the record straight.
Your mother knows. All of France will know by the time he returns.
Camille!
What? It's true, Georgette, and you know it.
Get out of here, blasted creatures! Wait a minute, sailor. A letter? What is an illiterate prisoner like you doing with a letter?
It's nothing, sir.
I shall be the judge of that. Dismissed! What do we have here? Roberval, you may want to see this.
What is it? I'm busy! How could she? That wayward girl! Did I not tell you, Claude? Did I not say that she would be the ruin of me? Oh, when word reaches France, we will be disgraced!
It will be a disaster.
I will be cast out of court!
If word ever reached France.
And how shall I keep this from being known in France? She is with child!
What if Marguerite never made it to France? No one would know the difference.
And what of the crew list? Wouldn't people ask as to her whereabouts?
That list could disappear quite easily, I'm sure. Roberval, this may turn out to be the best thing that could ever happen to you. To us.
The best thing? Are you mad?
Think about it. What would happen to Pontpoint if Marguerite were to never return?
Well, I would become the sole inheritor of Pontpoint.
And not just Pontpoint. But you would become heir of all of her land as well.
Claude, you're brilliant. I shall be rich and rid of her disgraceful ways all at the same time.
Now, of course, you should not be the only one who should benefit from this. My silence will cost you.
You would blackmail me, Claude?
Think of it more as a business opportunity. What do you say, Roberval? Poor? In France? Or let me in on the cut, and we both shall win.
I never should have saved your worthless skin 20 years ago. Fine, you shall be duly compensated. Go and get Marguerite and bring her to me. And what is that island called? Perfect.
Get up there!
Get off me! What do you want? I was rudely awakened from my nap and told you wanted me.
Rudeness is something you are quite familiar with. And let us be clear, I do not want you, Marguerite. That is the point.
Well, I can see that this is a waste of my time.
You are not dismissed. As captain of the ship, I order you to stay here.
Yes, captain.
Marguerite, is it true that you are with child?
With child? How ridiculous. Why would you think
I believe this proves it.
Where did you get that? Give it to me!
I will not pay for your foolishness! That, Marguerite, is to be your new home.
What? An island? I shall die out there! You cannot mean it!
It is my Christian duty.
Your Christian duty? I will die out there!
You have brought this on yourself! It is called the Island of Darkness on my map, feared by all who know of it. How fitting, I should think.
No, Uncle Roberval, no! You cannot mean it! I shall die! Oh, you cannot leave me there alone!
You will not be alone, Marguerite. You will have your baby. and your hand servant shall go with you as well.
No. No.
Claude, take her away.
No. No.
Get down there.
No. No, please.
Come on.
Please. You cannot do this, please. No. No, you cannot do this.
I can
no.
and
no.
I will.
No. No, please, please, no.
Serious. She is not worth it, I tell you. I have gotten rid of your problem.
I love her. Now draw your sword.
With pleasure. Take him below.
Yes, Captain. Oh, you can't! Get out of here! Get out of here!
Sailors, grab him! Put him in the stocks.
Yes, sir!
Here.
No, no, you cannot leave us here. Please, we will die.
I'm afraid it's Captain's orders, mademoiselle.
No, 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 this is murder.
There's nothing we can do, I'm afraid.
Please, please.
May God have mercy on you.
No, 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 Damien, what are we going to do?
I have no idea.
Oh, I'm so scared.
I'm scared too.
No! 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 The ship! Nicholas! Nicholas! Don't leave me! Don't leave us! Come back! Don't leave us! Please! No! 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 Oh, this is all my fault! And now we're going to die here! No! Oh, I'm so sorry, Damien! What have I done?
We cannot undo the past, Marguerite. But we can be forgiven. God forgives us when we ask.
God could never forgive me. Uncle Roberval said it himself. Oh, I'm getting exactly as I deserve!
'Tis true. Death is exactly what our sins deserve.
Then there's no hope. We're going to die here.
But there is hope, Marguerite. Jesus came to die for us. He took our punishment for us when he died on the cross. He died in our place. We need only to ask him for forgiveness.
If marooning me here is my Uncle Roberval's Christian duty, then I want nothing to do with his God!
Point of weary, is your burden weighing heavy? Is it all too much to carry? Let me tell you about my Jesus. Do you feel that empty feeling? 'Cause shame's done all it's stealing, and you're desperate for some healing. Tell you about my
Roberval does not know God. He only speaks of being a Christian so that others will think well of him. His actions prove that he is not. I fear he has not yet looked to Jesus to save him.
How do you know that? He says
God's
that...
God's presence in our lives changes us, Marguerite. When we are in Christ, we walk in the light, not in the darkness. Sir Roberval walks in the darkness. His deeds are evil.
They certainly are. He's the meanest, cruelest man I know. Leaving us here to die. Oh, Damien, I'm getting thirsty. How will we survive here without wine?
We shall drink water. Come, there must be a stream around here somewhere. Let's look.
Water? We can't drink water. It will kill us.
That's in France, Marguerite. Here, the water should be clean and pure.
Oh, wolves! I hate wolves! Now we shall most certainly die!
We must pray, Marguerite.
Yes, pray, Damien, quick!
Dear Father in Heaven, we thank...
Ask him to save us from the wolves, Damien!
We thank you that you are here with us, even on this...
Oh, the wolves are coming for us, Damien!
Nicholas?
Damien, where is Marguerite?
Oh, Nicholas, is it really you? You don't have to pray anymore, Damien. Nicholas is here!
But how did you get here, Nicholas?
The sailors, when they grabbed me, they held me loosely, and I jumped overboard into the water.
But I thought you were terrified of the water.
Me? Scared of water? I'm only terrified of losing my Marguerite forever.
But how are we going to survive here? We're stuck, and we shall all die!
Nonsense! We will not die. We will live! It is only the start of summer, and we have everything here we need to establish a new colony. A smaller, temporary colony.
Then we shall just have to make sure that everything lasts. We will only take supplies out of the trunk when it is absolutely necessary.
Oh, and you will save us, and we shall all return back to France, right?
I...
Please, Nicholas, oh, promise me that you will save us.
I promise, Marguerite.
But there are wolves here.
Didn't I tell you I would protect you from all the wolves of France?
Yes, you did, my brave hunter.
And this is a much smaller piece of land than France. Come, we have much work to do. I'm going to collect sticks for a fire.
Nicholas, you shouldn't make promises that you can't keep.
I only hope I can, Damien.
Mosquitoes almost ate me alive. I have some wild onion for your soup. What kind are we having today?
Rabbits. But this is the last of our meat. The drying rack's empty. Marguerite and I will go fishing later today. Hopefully we catch something, or we shall soon be hungry once again.
Where is Marguerite anyway?
How are the trap lines today?
Some of the bait was gone, but the traps were empty. Not even a squirrel, I'm afraid. There's nothing, no stupid traps, empty. Oh, I think I saw signs of a bear.
A bear? On the island? Do you really think so?
I saw white fur in the tree. I've heard about these bears. They're mean. They go searching in the water, looking for food. But imagine shooting a bear.
Just make sure you get him on the first shot. An angry bear would be a formidable foe.
Yes, But if we did get it, we'd have meat for weeks, and we'd have a warm fur coat for winter.
That would be nice. The nights are getting colder. I fear the snow will soon come.
Yes, I'm afraid you're right. It is winter. Have you marked the tree yet today?
No, not today. Why don't you do it?
All right. I shall. Don't do that, Marguerite!
Oh, did you really think I was a bear? Oh, I'm only the size of a bear. Help me up. Nicholas,
no.
Help me up!
You don't deserve my help.
Oh, Nicholas, help me up!
All right. But only because you're so beautiful.
And you are my brave hunter who jumps like a little girl when a bear comes.
Is that so?
Yes.
Well, then I think it's time I teach you how to shoot.
Nicholas, I could never shoot a gun.
I seem to recall telling you that I would teach you someday. And I think now is the time. With winter coming, we need to stockpile as much food as we can. If you can help with the hunting, then I can focus on running more traps. I really think it's necessary if we are to survive the winter.
If you really think so. Oh, but it will terrify me.
You'll be fine. I'll set up some targets.
Fine, I'll get the powder. But just so you know, I'm never shooting a bear.
You may have to. I'd rather eat him than him eat us.
Oh, Damien, is something wrong? What's wrong? What's the matter?
Oh, Marguerite. Oh, it is so wicked of me.
What is wicked of you? You are the kindest person I know.
It is so hard. I see you and Nicholas so happy. And I get...
Get what?
Sometimes I just feel jealous, I suppose. Oh. It sounds so wicked when I say it out loud.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I don't mean to hurt you.
I long to find someone who will love me. And there
aren't exactly a lot of coachmen here to choose from.
Exactly.
Damien, I am so, so sorry. This is all my fault, and now you have to pay for it. Can you find it in your heart to forgive me, sweet Damien?
Yes, Marguerite, I forgive you. Now, it looks like you're ready for your shooting lesson.
All right, now, pull this back, hold it firmly, look down at the pine cone, and when you are ready, gently squeeze here.
Will it hurt?
It might, but that's why you have to hold it firmly in your shoulder.
Great.
Don't take your eye off the target. All right, keep your feet planted and aim at the pine cone. And when you're ready, shoot. I'll get out of the way so you don't shoot me.
Oh, did I hit it?
It's hard to hit the target with your eyes closed. You have to keep your eye on the target, Marguerite. You only get one shot. If you miss, it takes too long to reload. Your prey will run away. Or at you. All right, there we go. Let's try one more time. Here.
Okay.
Keep your eye on the target.
Target. Okay.
There. Oh, wait. I have to set the pine cone back up.
Oh.
There we go.
Okay.
Wait, Marguerite, wait.
No! Oh, Nicholas! Oh, are you okay?
a good thing you don't have very good aim.
Oh, thank goodness you're all right. I thought I had killed you.
That was my point. You could have killed me.
What a horrible thing to do!
Horrible? You almost shot me!
Now that you are alive, I could kill you for such a nasty trick!
I'm sorry, Marguerite, but you almost shot me. It was a loaded gun. What were you thinking?
You told me don't take my eye off the target, so I didn't!
Yes, but not when I'm in front of you.
Well, I didn't see you. My eye was on the target. How was I supposed to know you'd be stupid enough to run right in front of me?
So now I'm stupid.
Yes!
I told you to wait!
This is all your fault!
All my fault?
Yes, all your fault making me shoot that gun!
I'm trying my best, all right? I built the raft.
Yeah, well, that's not good enough. It didn't get further than stone's throw before it broke apart and dumped us all in the waves!
I'm trying my best, aren't I?
That's not good enough! I want to be saved off this island when you promised you would! I just want to go home to all the food I can eat and beautiful dresses and balls. I just want to be happy again. Oh, and dance again. We shall die here. We're all going to die here.
Marguerite, you shouldn't upset yourself so. Come over to the fire.
It's time I finish these wolves once and for all.
Nicholas, must you?
I'm afraid if I don't finish them, they will finish us. They get closer every day. Take care of her, Damien.
Please be careful, Nicholas. Marguerite, are you okay?
No.
Marguerite, you shouldn't upset yourself so. You have the baby to think about.
I know. And I think that's what I'm so scared about, Damien. The baby's coming so soon. How am I going to manage? All alone.
But you will not be all alone, Marguerite.
But look where we are! On an island in the woods, all full of mosquitoes and flies! Giving birth in a stick hut!
Our precious savior was born in a stable. This could not be any better than that.
No, I suppose it wasn't.
Except Jesus chose to do that for us, to come and be born in a stable. And then he died for us to bring us salvation.
But I just want saving off this island, and Nicholas,
he said— It is unfair of you to put so much pressure on Nicholas. He's doing his best. Marguerite, the truth is, God is the only one you truly need.
Well, he hasn't gotten us off this island.
He came to Earth not to save us from an island, but from something much worse, our lives of sin without him. And Jesus is the only one who can do that. You need to turn to him, not anyone else, even Nicholas. Now, I think it's time for us to get something new out of the chest.
Should we, Damien? Oh, what should we get?
Here, take that. All right. How about this blanket?
Oh, it's so soft and so warm.
Winter is coming soon, and the nights are getting colder.
Oh, Nicholas! Nicholas, are you all right? What happened?
Oh. Was it the wolves, Nicholas?
Yes. I was aiming at one. Another one came up behind me.
No. But you knew that. You said it yourself in front.
never seen a wolf then in France. Oh. I made it up to impress you. I'm smarter than I thought.
Oh, Nicholas, you're bleeding all over.
Here, Marguerite, help me sit him up.
Is he going to be all right, Damien?
I don't know. It looks like he's lost a lot of blood. I'll go get the blanket.
Oh, Nicholas, you must get better. Oh, I need you. I cannot survive without you.
I'm sorry. Marguerite. I love you. Marguerite.
Oh, I love you too. I love you, Nicholas.
Please, no.
No. No. No. No.
Please, no.
No.
Rest for
just after my dear Nicholas died. Her baby was born. Such a precious little one. A baby girl. I named her Georgette, after my beloved friend. She lived for only 12 days. Hunger was our constant companion and worst enemy, and I did not have enough milk for her. My heart broke when she died. Poor wee one. The winter here has been harsher than anything I could ever imagine. I am quite certain baby Georgette could not have survived it. Never have I felt such bitter cold. Cold I couldn't even imagine was possible. Damien grew ill, weakening by the day. She tried desperately to hold on for my sake, but at the end of April, she too left me. Now I'm alone. Spring has come again, and oh, I'm alone. Damien, you promised me you would never leave me. Oh, and now you're gone. Oh, and my little darling Georgette. Oh, I miss you. My arms, they ache for you. Nicholas, you said you would save us. My dear Nicholas, you told us you would save us. Nicholas, help me up. Oh, thank you for joining me. I'll race you to the trunk. Oh, you're gonna have to run faster than that if you want to beat me. You look very beautiful today, my good lady. Oh, why, thank you, my brave hunter. Oh, Damien, what dress would you like me to put on you today? I don't know. Well, so many to choose from. Why don't you get the green one? Oh, I think the green one looks beautiful on you. Thank you. I am the captain of this ship, and you shall do as I say. Now scrub the deck, or I shall have you hanged to the mainsail, you scum-sucking varmint! Help me, oh, help me, I'm drowning. Monsieur Claude, help me. Oh, I'm coming, Roberval, I'm coming. Oh, birds, birds. Oh, help me, I'm drowning, help me. Oh, shouldn't we help him, Marguerite? No.
Leave him. Let him drown. I hate him. Servant, will you go get me some more wood for the fire? As you wish, mademoiselle.
Do you really think that they could still be alive?
I can only hope! Marguerite! Monsieur Dupont, can we get a lifeboat? Go and look for them!
Sir Roberval won't stop, I'm afraid. I begged him.
What a wicked man! They may be still alive, and he sails right by, dooming them to their death!
Honestly, Georgette, I don't think they could have survived that winter. Marie didn't. There's nothing here but famine, cold, and sickness.
I know. I know! And that's why it's a miracle we're surviving, any of us, to return to France alive. I had just hoped, maybe, that Marguerite might still be alive.
It's impossible. With our supplies, we lost 50 settlers last winter from scurvy. Jacques Cartier knew no one could survive here. That's why his ships were leaving when we arrived.
I guess.
He had already lost so many, Georgia.
I suppose that's why he defied Sir Roberval's order to return to the new colony with us.
Indeed, and knowing what I do now, I too wish I had fled in the night with Cartier back to France.
But Sir Roberval was furious. But he is a wicked man, marooning people on islands, forcing the men to work, otherwise depriving them of food and drink, punishing them so ruthlessly.
And how many times did he have to suppress an uprising? Yet still Roberval returns to France with his barrels full of gold and diamonds in the hold.
The price paid by those left behind, including my dear Marguerite. Goodbye, my dear Marguerite!
Stop!
to die here. There's no one to save me here.
Light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life.
The light of life. I don't want to live in darkness anymore. Jesus, Jesus, I need you. Oh, I need your light. Please forgive me of my sins and bring me into your light. I want to follow you. I want to follow you.
Thank you.
regain my strength and give me a steady shot.
Ooh la la, what is this? Philippe, Marcel, come quick, vite, vite.
Oh God, what are you yelling about now?
Ooh la la, would you look at this?
A camp? No one can live here. Impossible.
But there is the food we eat. I am so tired of the fish.
But look at these furs. Oh, mighty hunters must live here. They I do not wish to meet.
Dastu, c'est bon, it is so good, you must try some.
We could fight these mighty hunters.
We have been mere fishermen.
Ah, but some of us fishermen are better than others, oui, Marcel?
Marcel, Philippe makes you the joke of many, but...
And look at your puny muscles, Philippe. You cannot fight off a trois-legged lapin. A three-legged bonnet would be too much for you, eh?
But look at these pelts. We could take these furs. We could make a lot of money back in France. Oui, oui, Marcel?
And end up like this guy, Philippe, to make stew out of?
Perhaps they were the last fishermen who tried to steal these hunters' furs. No, we shall not take anything, and we shall leave here before they come back.
I do not wish to meet such mighty men. Call me a scaredy dog. I don't care. I don't wish to become stew. Let's go, Philippe!
Let's go! I don't know how I put up with you guys.
We promised we did not take anything.
Oh, thank the Lord you have come. Oh, thank God. Thank you that you heard my prayers.
What is she doing?
I have no idea.
Oh, thank God you have come. Oh, you are an answer to my prayers.
That is the first time Marcel has been an answer to any woman's prayers.
Philippe, quiet. Who are you, madame?
My name is Marguerite Delaroc of France.
We too are from France.
Oui. So please do not call the mighty hunters. We mean no harm.
Mighty hunters? What mighty hunters?
Where are the men?
Oh, there are no men. Oh, I have stew. Are you hungry?
No, no stew, no mercy.
But... What do you mean, no men?
Well, I'm alone.
You live here? Alone? On this island? Impossible!
It's true. I was marooned here by my uncle. Oh, he left me here to die.
Your uncle left you here all by you alone?
Yes. Well, along with my two other friends. But they did not survive. This little cross here is for my baby, who also died.
I'm so sorry, madame.
But all these animals, who killed these animals?
Oh, I did.
All of these?
Yes, with God's help.
But this is a polar bear, the most dangerous and ferocious.
Well, I've shot three.
Ooh la la, the lady is a mighty hunter.
How did madame do this? He will kill you!
No, I actually had a good teacher.
Keep your eye on the target. Oh, and pray.
How long ago did your friends die?
Duncan, she died 320 days ago.
You have been here alone for nearly a year. How did you survive?
I survived! I survived! Oh, I didn't think I would! I survived! Oh, I survived here. But I desperately want to leave here. Can you take me back to France with you?
It would be an honor to escort such a brave lady such as yourself, madame. Philippe, Hugo, pack up these things. Man, we are taking this lady with us.
I will get the food.
I'm sure you will.
Be careful. We don't want to ruin the bird.
Okay.
No blue dress.
No.
Okay, very good. Oh, this is heavy. My back is going to kill me.
Don't forget the stew.
Oh, yes.
I'll put it down.
Are you coming, madame?
Yes, may I just have a moment?
Oui, take as long as you need.
You won't leave me, will you?
No, we will, how do you say, but stay.
Merci. My precious little Georgette. How I wish things could have been different. Oh, and that you had a chance to survive, to live your life. You shall always be in my heart. Oh, Nicholas. My brave hunter. Oh, I asked too much from you. Expecting more than you could ever give me. Oh, I know that now. I'm sorry. Please forgive me, Nicholas. Oh, I love you. Damien. Oh, Damien. My dear, sweet Damien. Oh, so wise and good. I met your God. The one who has never left me. The only one who can save me. Not just from this island, but from myself. You were right. He is all I need. My loved ones.
Thank you.
Poor Marguerite, all alone on that island. Did she ever get back to France?
Yes, she did. And as her story was told, Marguerite was looked upon with esteem and honor for having survived such an ordeal. King Francis's sister even wrote a book on our Marguerite's story. It was called Heptameron.
Wow, so she really was a real lady.
Yes, she was. In fact, I myself am that lady, Louise.
You're Marguerite de la Roque, teacher?
Yes, I am.
But you can't be teacher.
And why not?
Because you said she was spoiled and selfish. And you're not selfish, teacher. You're the kindest person I know.
Thank you, Louise.
And Sir Robert Vow was really your uncle?
Yes, he was.
He is terrible! He left you to die and got rich!
Actually, he didn't. The gold and diamonds he returned with turned out to be fool's gold and quartz. It was all worthless. We French have a saying, as false as Canadian diamonds.
I've heard that!
Well, this is where the saying comes from. Roberval came back with what he thought was a great treasure, but it turned out to be nothing. I came back with the greatest treasure that I could ever have, even though I came back with nothing.
But you lost your home, Pond Point, and your land? It's not fair!
Yes, Roberval returned, and he got Pond Point. But as soon as he came back to France, the creditors seized it all. He got nothing. There was nothing left.
What happened to Sir Roberval? Is he still alive? Did you get revenge?
I did not seek revenge. It was a long time ago. I left the matter in God's hands. In 1560, Roberval was murdered in Paris. As it says, those who live by the sword...
die by the sword. I still don't think it's fair. You lost everything.
What I lost on the island showed me that there was only one thing that I can keep for all eternity. And I couldn't have them both. Come, Louise. Would you read something for me?
I can try.
Excellent. Here. John 12:46. This is Jesus speaking.
I have come into the world as light.
Oh, when did Jesus come into the world?
At Christmas time, teacher.
That's right, Louise. Now keep reading.
So that whoever believes in me may not remain in darkness.
And why does it say he came?
So that we will not remain in darkness.
That's right. When we believe in Jesus, he takes us up out of the darkness and brings us into his light. We don't have to live in the darkness anymore because the light has come. That is your Christmas present, Louise.
That's better than a dress.
Yes, it is. I learned this the hard way, all alone on that island. But it was there that he brought me out of the darkness.
I don't live on an island, but sometimes I feel all alone.
I know you do. But this message is here for anyone, at any time.
Including me?
Yes, especially including you. That is why I started a school here, so that children can learn to read the Bible for themselves and know the truth. God's word is powerful, Louise. It changed my life.
Then I want to learn how to read.
And you will. You just have to keep practicing. Now, it's time to run up to bed. It's Christmas Eve.
God sent his son as a light in the darkness. I don't have to be afraid of the dark anymore, do I, teacher?
No, you don't. Ask him. Ask ask him to give you his light.
I will. Good night. Good night, my sweet little one.
Joy to